Hello, everybody, and welcome to the After School Club. I'm Eric Nam.
Hello, and I'm Kevin.
Yes, as many of you are aware, all of Korea is in deep sadness and mourning right now. Out of respect for those who were affected by the tragedy, we spent a week off air, and yesterday we offered our condolences and messages of hope to everybody affected by this tragedy.
Yes, and we'd like to thank all of our ASC family who joined us in paying tribute to all those affected. And on today's show, we'll be talking about our loved ones and people who give us strength. And also we'll be meeting ASCers who will tell us about who gives them strength as well.
Yes. We're going to be hearing from ASCers about their closest strength and their people around them. And a lot of them have actually prepared songs for them and for us to share with you guys. Okay. A lot of people who couldn't join us live also sent in video messages. So we're going to go ahead and take a look right now.
Out to all of the affected in South Korea incident, and I just hope that everyone knows that the whole world is by this guy.
Although we may not speak the same language, and we may not be in the same country, one thing is universal. Family. I offer my condolences as I cannot begin to imagine how difficult the situation has been.
I'm very sad to hear the news about tragic sinking of the Seoul ferry a few days ago. Deep condolence for all the victims and their families. I'm sure that many people in Korea was in a difficult time right now. Hopefully, all the people who still missing could be found. And all who have died, I wish they are blessed by God.
Most of them were our age, so that's why I think it also affected me more. You know what? I really hope that those parents do stay strong. The family members, like, yes, it's a hard time. I wish the whole nation of SK could also stay strong.
Because I know what it's like to lose family members. Since I've lost two of mine last year, and I can feel what they're feeling. It's not that easy.
That should have never happened. I know how it is to lose relatives because I lost both my grandparents the same year, which was 2 years ago. So I understand the pain and the loss.
Tragic things happen. It's important for a community to come together, be brave, and most importantly, be thankful for everything that one still has.
I hope that all the friends and families of the victims could fight through this incident, thinking that there are actually people out there who thinks about the victims too.
They should not lose hope. And they should keep praying for their family members to be found. And for those that have lost their family members in this tragedy, that they will know that they are not alone. And they have many supporters around the world praying for them.
We want the friends and the family of the victims of the tragic ferry incident to know that we are here to support, pray, and give our condolences to those who have lost a life.
I can say, try to be strong, okay? There's a lot of people with you supporting.
South Korea, stay strong. We'll keep praying for you.
Thank you so much for everybody sending in those video messages.
Thank you.
After our show yesterday, I don't know about you, I'm sure you did too.
Yeah.
I felt that words of encouragement and of love really help hold us strong and provide a good backing in times of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the people around us that really help a lot as well.
Exactly, right? That's right. So today, we wanted to take some time to talk about those who are closest to us. And on yesterday's show, we talked briefly about who we're closest to and who help us when we want to lean on somebody. So Eric, who is closest to you or who comes to mind for you?
I mean, naturally, the first people that come to mind are probably my family,
family,
my relatives.
Of course, yes.
Probably, you know, my mom and dad are very, very supportive. And then my younger brother, Eddie, is very, very supportive. And They're just my biggest fans and supporters. But they're all abroad, so it's not as easy to have them around. But people in Korea, maybe I'd say, my manager,
your manager.
Or my producers at Sweettune, they actually helped me a lot through any difficult situations.
Especially, it must have been hard for you to adjust to the Korean culture when you first came. And I'm sure the first people that you met have helped you along the way.
Exactly.
Like your friends from,
From my show. Yeah, they've helped a lot as well. So I think now that I've been here for a little bit, I have a strong support system
foundation.
To kind of keep me grounded and help me when I need someone to lean on. But
cool.
What about yourself, Kevin?
Of course, like you said, my family, my mom, my dad, my sister.
Mm-hmm.
Also a big, big help, of course, my members. Because I'm always with them 24/7.
Yeah.
And if you think about it, like I spend more time with them than I do with my family.
Mm.
So we know best about each other. And when we're all, you know, when someone's having a rough time, we're always there for each other. Like recently, a loved one passed away, and I was with my members, and they were the first ones to know about this, about that.
The loss,
and they helped me. They gave me strength.
Mm.
They gave me words of encouragement,
mm-hmm.
and I just felt so blessed to have such people around me. And
That's great.
I'd like to thank also my fans, and also ASC. Family is always there for us when we're having a hard time.
Yeah.
So we'd like to say thank you so much.
Thank you. On that note, it's about time to hear from our ASC family. We want to know who the people closest to you are, who gives you the support when you're down, when you're having struggles or times of difficulty. So we're going to go ahead and read a couple of your messages that have been sent
in.
All right.
We have a few tweets that came in. Why don't you read one, Eric?
This is from Rama Vitria. My mom. I often cry in front of her, even on the phone too. I tell her everything. She's always on my side. Yes, be sure to tell your mom you love her. That's something that I think everybody can do more often.
Mm.
Tell the people around them that they love them.
Exactly.
Right?
Sometimes it's hard for us to say that on a daily basis because we forget.
Yeah, we forget. It can be awkward. It can be weird. Like I remember the first time I told my parents that I love them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I love them,
and
but you don't actually really say that. But it takes a lot to be able to say that. But once you do,
it's very simple.
Yeah.
Just saying I love you could make a big difference.
Try it.
Yeah,
everyone
should try it. All right, our next tweet is from Jocelyn, my mom. She's my best friend, my guardian angel, and my mom.
It's
a lot of sweet words to their mothers.
Let's see, top. HPod 12. Mom, dad, and brother, they know me so well.
Mm-hmm.
They can tell even before I get home when something's wrong, I love them a lot. Yeah, family.
Yeah, that's a really good mention right there. Because when I come home, they know everything.
Uh-huh.
Even though I don't really tell them personally, they could just tell
they
by looking into my eyes.
And
I think that's just love right there.
Mm-hmm.
Just not, even without words, you know how someone's feeling. And you know when to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And just want to thank my parents.
All right. We have another one from Taryn. My best friend Brianna has helped me so much the past 3 years while I struggled with health problems and depression. Love her.
Best friends.
Yes.
Yeah.
Friends. That's what friends are for, right?
Yeah,
friends can be family. Friends are family.
Exactly. And friends, you could relate to them even more. You know, probably more than your parents because you guys are the same age.
Mm-hmm.
You guys go through the same things.
Similar experiences.
Some things you can't talk as easily as you can with your parents. Friends are always going to be there for you. So I encourage making best friends for life.
Yes.
All right, next we've got Aya. My friends, at first we held a bond because of K-pop, but now it's more than that. I really love them. Wish us luck for college. Good luck, guys.
Good luck. Let's see. Who else do we have?
Let's
just keep scrolling down.
A lot of parents, mom and dad.
Yeah, I see a lot of mom and dad. A lot of
best
friends.
Cousins, also.
But yeah, if you guys, I don't know. I feel like, you know, there might be people who are watching who's like, oh, I don't feel like I have that connection with some people. But, you know, even those people, I encourage you to reach out.
Yeah, reaching out is also a big step.
Reach out. don't be shy, don't be nervous, and try to find people who surround yourself with very, very good people. Mm. You know, at least you have us as well, right? So you can reach out to us.
You guys have us, exactly.
But I think anywhere you are, whoever you are, it's very important to have solid, well-grounded, strong relationships with the people around you.
Exactly.
So,
all right, we have another tweet from Laura M. When I need comfort, I always talk with my grandma. She's my everything, and I play with her little dog, and she rises my mood. Cool.
Grandma.
Even pets.
Pets.
Yeah, pets also can be a big help in bringing up your mood.
All right, let's read one more.
Okay. That was our last tweet.
That was it. All right. Okay. So we've heard friends, family, pets.
Pets, yeah.
A lot of people. Us.
ASC.
Yeah. So very, very different types of people. But now we want to talk to some ASUers live about the closest people to them.
All right.
So let's go ahead and get connected on our Hangout. Hello.
Okay, hello. Hello, we have Lacey from the USA.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Kevin.
Hi. How are you?
I heard
you're good. How are you?
Good.
I heard you're a student.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna graduate in 12 days. I feel old.
Oh, you're graduating high school, college?
High school.
High school.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yay. Only 12 more days. Good luck with that. And we're just curious, when you're feeling down, who gives you the most strength? And who's always there that you could lean on?
Both my brothers and my mom give me the most strength because they always listen to me when I need to vent. They offer advice when I need it, and they always give me hugs when my days get too bad.
Yeah.
Oh, sweet hugs.
My brother Corey tries to make me laugh when I finish venting. And my brother Kyle gives me suggestions. And my mom's my best friend, and she just can tell when something's wrong with me because she immediately is just like, come here, let me hold you.
Oh, yeah, okay. It's really sweet of her, and I know how that feels because...
But they aren't the only ones, too.
They aren't the only ones. All right, who else can you lean on?
They aren't the only ones. Actually, I kind of lean on K-pop because...
K-pop.
You, like you two, for example, I listen to your voices, I watch performances of you guys, and I see you guys reply to fans just like me. And I remember, Eric, you replied to a girl on Instagram about losing her grandmother, and that really touched my heart, even though she wasn't me. So I feel like you guys aren't just people I look up to, but you guys are also my friends.
Yeah, we're right next to you.
Yeah, we're right there with you. So, I mean, everybody goes through hard times. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think for us, even, you know, we have people around us that support us, but we try to be people who are supportive as well.
Exactly.
So, if you can play that role to anybody, that's awesome.
I just want to thank you guys, too, because we hear that you guys lean on us when you guys are having a rough time. But the other way around, we really want to thank you guys for always being there for us as well.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So, Lacey, how about, you know, do you want to take some time to say, you know, send a message to your family? Something that, I don't know, it might be hard to say
personally.
But, you know, since we're talking about
family,
saying I love yous and everything, anything you want to say?
Mom, Corey, Kyle, I just want to thank you guys for always being there for me when I need you. Because you're always here, and I know I seem to need you guys a lot, but it means a lot to me that you never get tired of me, and you always find the time to hold me and dry my tears. And I hope you guys know that I'm here for you, too, whenever you need me. Just call my name, and I'll be right there. I love you more than anything in this world.
All right. That's so sweet.
Don't cry. Go tell them. When we're done, go tell them you love them and give them a big hug, all right?
Yeah, give them a big hug right now.
All right.
We love you, too.
Be sure that you're someone that can give someone else strength as well. I'm sure you're doing a great job, but stay strong. Hang in there, and we'll talk to you again very, very soon, all right?
Okay. Thank you for your time, Lacey.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Love you.
Bye.
Love you too.
Stay strong.
All right. Okay. Stay strong.
Thank you so much. Next up, we have Victoria from the USA.
Yes.
Hi, Victoria.
Hi.
Hi, Victoria.
How are you?
Hello. I'm good.
All right, Victoria, today we're talking about people who give us strength in hard times. So do you have anybody that comes to mind?
Oh, so many people come to mind. Mm. When I think of those people, I think of great spiritual leaders, musicians, and definitely my family as well, especially my parents.
Okay. Exactly. That's awesome. And can you tell us about a time when they helped you get through something like that?
Yeah, actually, just a few months ago, a friend of mine who was an exchange student the year I graduated high school, she was from Brazil. She had gone back home, and a few months later, we suddenly started seeing messages, and she had unexpectedly passed away.
Oh,
just suddenly gotten sick. And that distressed me a lot. The first person I ran to was my mom. And she just let me cry on her shoulder.
That must have been a very tough time for you, Victoria.
Yeah, it was really unexpected. My parents helped me get through that grief process, gave me suggestions of techniques and stuff to do. Decorated a picture of her and lit a candle. I kept it going for weeks.
Okay.
All right. Well, there may be some people watching right now who feel like they don't have somebody to turn to, who, you know, might be feeling a little lonely or don't have that support system.
Yeah.
So do you have anything that you could suggest to them or any words that you could say to them to give them some strength and courage?
I want to tell them that I love them, even though I don't know who they are. I want to tell them that it's just because they're human beings, and human beings are amazing, powerful creatures.
Yeah.
And it's okay to feel, it's okay to cry, and it's better to go through these things than around.
And they'll
just become more amazing for it.
You're an angel, Victoria, and we don't want to thank you. We'd like to thank you for sharing your thoughts and your advices. And we thank you so much for joining us today.
All right.
You're welcome.
So much, Victoria. Thanks for your strong words. Hang in there.
Hang in there. And, stay strong, Victoria.
Yes, thank you for sharing your experiences with us. All right?
All right. Thank you. Bye.
All right, before we go on, we're going to take a short break by watching a music video that was requested by our ASEers. We'll be watching Isengi's Invitation to Me.
Okay.
We'll be right back in just a few moments.
Yeah. 언제나 혼자란 생각에
All right, that was Isengi's Invitation to Me, which is requested by a lot of our ASCers.
Yes, on today's After School Club, we're talking about the people who are closest to us. Right?
Yes, and in times like these, we realize how blessed we are to be able to share our everyday experiences with the people around us, right, Eric?
Yes, the recent tragedy has made me think a lot. I'm sure both of us, everybody around us, think a lot about what's valuable.
Yeah.
You know, who is around us? Who do we love? Who is surrounding us?
Who is always there for us? Yeah.
And I think the most important thing in life is relationships, right? It's who do we live with? Who are we friends with? What do we do?
Who do we learn with? Who do we grow with?
Yeah, the people and the love and the relationships really help us through the times that are difficult and dark and just even through the happy and good times.
Exactly. And we'll continue with more Hangouts right now. Mm-hmm. And we'll be meeting people who hope to express their support and their love for everyone in hard times through music.
Yes.
So next up, we have Lena.
Lena
from Canada, and she is going to share.
Hi, Lena.
Hi.
Hello.
All right, hello. Welcome back.
Hi.
We had you on a few weeks ago, I believe, right?
We had you on our ASC contest. We remember you.
All right, cool.
All right,
cool.
And today we're talking about the people we turn to when we have rough times. And we want to know, who do you turn to?
I always turn to my friends since I have a supportive and understanding group of them. Mm-hmm. And I always trust and love them to tell them like how I feel. Mm-hmm. And I have this one friend that I can just always go to and just cry in her arms.
Aww.
And she wouldn't have to ask me a question or anything. She just knows that I just need someone
to lean on. Great.
So then
and I also,
yeah, go ahead.
I also have my sister that I always tell everything to, and she gives me great advice to help me get through the hard times.
Okay. Yeah. That's great. So you have a great support system around you, but just in turn, how do you act when you feel like or you know somebody needs your help or someone's a little down? Is there anything you do in particular?
I would first ask if they're okay and tell them that if they do need someone to lean on, since they do seem like they don't have anyone, I would say I would be there for them and I would be here for them all the time and I would give them a hug and say some words of encouragement.
Yeah, hugs are very powerful.
Hugs are very powerful.
Yeah.
They release very good hormones in the brain, actually.
Good energy, good vibes.
Everybody should give hugs.
Everyone should hug more often. And Lena, I heard that you're going to be singing a song for us today that will give comfort and hope to those who are in dark times. And what will you be singing for us today?
I will be singing Over the Rainbow.
Over the Rainbow. Okay. Great song.
All right, whenever you're ready.
Somewhere over the rainbow,
way up high. There's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow skies are blue. And the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops, and that's where you'll find me.
All right. Thank you. Lena, thank you for that wonderful rendition.
You have a beautiful voice.
Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Mm. I love that song.
Yeah.
It's a very, very uplifting song.
Uplifting, yeah. Very soothing voice you have. And we want to thank you for sharing your song with us and to everyone who's watching.
All right. Well, Lena, thank you so much again for hanging out with us. And hopefully we'll be able to talk to you again very, very soon.
Okay.
Be sure to be a big, positive, lovable person to everybody around you. All right?
All right. Bye.
Bye-bye. All right, next up we have Sarah Amanda calling in from Malaysia.
Hello, Sarah.
Oh. Hey. Hi.
How are you?
How are you?
Good. Are you doing okay?
I'm good.
All right.
Great.
So Sarah, today we're talking about the people who are closest to us. Who would you consider to be the closest people around you?
I would probably say my best friend, Islin, my brother, my sister, and music has been a really good friend of mine.
Music.
My brother has always been there for me. Whenever I have problems, I can always tell him about it.
Great. So when you're going through tough times, what do you do to get through it?
Well, mostly I just sit in my room and just cry it all out alone.
Mm.
And then after a while, I will get back to my old self. And yeah.
Sometimes you just gotta let it all out, all the tears.
You do.
Yeah.
It's good. You need to release it. Mm. So very, very good. Sarah, we heard that you also prepared a song for us today. What did you prepare?
Yeah, I'm going to sing Safe and Sound by Taylor Swift and Civil Wars.
Okay.
It's a really calming song, and it will take us all on a ride to reminisce and look back on the people and the things we love, like reminding us they're always there for us, like nostalgia, but the welcoming one. I hope you guys enjoy this song as much as I do.
All right.
Thank you.
Let's hear it.
Love this song.
All right. On your face when I said I'll never leave you shy. All the shadows almost killed your life. I remember you said, don't leave me here alone. All that's dead and gone and passed tonight. Just close your eyes, sun is going down. You'll be alright, no one can hurt you now. Come morning light, you and I'll be safe and sound. Don't you dare look out your window, darling, everything's on fire. The war outside our door keeps raging on. Hold on to this lullaby, even when the music's gone. Just close your eyes, sun is going down. You'll be alright, no one can hurt you now. Come morning light,
you and I'll be safe. Wow.
Oh.
Thank you.
Yes.
That was beautiful.
It was very, very, very nice. Wow. Love your voice. Mm. Love that song. Very, very great rendition, I think. Very good for healing, I think.
Healing. You know, I'm sure a lot of people were healed through this song who are watching right now. So thank you so much.
Well, Sarah, thank you so much for joining us and sharing your talent and your voice and that song with us. And please continue to be a positive light in the world, all right?
Just don't forget to sing more often to the people who you love, because it just gives so much strength to everyone around you. So stay strong.
Thanks, Sarah, for joining us. Talk to you soon. Love you.
Thank you.
Bye.
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 I love you too.
Bye. All right. All right, we're going to be back after watching a music video, so stay tuned and stay with us. We'll be right back.
Yes, that was BAP's coffee shop. And want to read some more tweets?
Yep, we're going to go to our Twitter to read some more messages that are coming in right now. All right, this is from Gwen Deanna. ASC shares the sadness to the one you love, best friend, or listening to music, or go for a holiday.
Holiday. All right, next up we have
Hey Jung-woo.
Listen to music or just write down what makes you sad.
Yeah, I actually do that a lot too.
You write down
I write a lot.
Your thoughts?
Yeah. We also have from Jigyun's Mide. Spend lots of time with your family. They know you the best and can always make you laugh.
Yes. Every chance I get, I spend with my family, especially because I can't see them a lot throughout my busy schedule.
Yeah, I'm sure.
So
I'm
whenever I get that chance, I always go out to grab dinner with them or watch a movie or even, you know, just play sports or anything that we could really connect with.
Is there anything in particular that you do or watch or listen to that kind of helps bring you healing or relieve stress?
Of course, to me, music is a big factor in my life. And every time I'm either happy or feeling kind of down, music is always there. It's always available.
Yeah.
And just listening to music really makes me calm down.
Yeah.
And just songs that you listen to, some of the lyrics that you can relate to are important because you feel the same way as the artist does, and I can really connect with that.
Yeah.
How about you?
Yeah. For me, I'd say I'm similar in that I listen to a lot of music.
Yeah.
I also try to write a lot,
Write a lot of music.
So a lot of lyrics, I think, come from not only when you're happy and you're having a good time, but when you're having a difficult time, when you're heartbroken and you're sad or you're stressed or you're frustrated. And
that's a great idea.
Writing all that down kind of relieves that stress, and I can kind of focus on and analyze what I'm thinking and how I'm feeling.
Yeah.
So that helps a lot. And then the other thing I like to do is either just go for a long walk by myself somewhere like by the river or or treat myself to,
I do that too.
Or to dessert or go get ice cream or something.
Something that makes you feel better or something that makes you forget about.
Yeah, or a holiday or something like that. So
that's all right, let's read some more tweets.
Mm-hmm.
We also have
Jihoon Kees.
She says, lots of alone time to reflect and think about the good instead of the bad. And the music and time heals the best.
Yes, that is true. That's the other thing. When you're having a hard time, there's always people who are having a harder time.
Exactly.
That's I actually do think that a lot. And really, to be thankful in times of difficulty.
Appreciate what you really have and your blessings.
Mm-hmm.
Always be grateful.
This is from Pika Genie. There's always a reason to smile. Tell yourself that it's easier to keep going while it's tougher to stop and waste time. That's a good way to think about it. Yeah.
All right. Next we have B. Vin. Keep calm, pray and hopes. Sharing your problems with someone. I always keep for myself and hold the pain alone. All right. There's also some people who like to be alone in times of sadness.
Yeah.
And I understand that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some people, you know, cope better when they're alone, but don't stay alone for too long because that's can be very, very, very sad. You know, I've tried that too, being alone for a long time, and it works for
at some point.
Time.
You need someone to talk.
So always talk to somebody or express yourself in some way.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's about all we have for our tweets. Let's go ahead to our next hangout. I believe we have Aaron North from the States calling in. Hello, Aaron.
Hello, Aaron.
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
Hi.
I'm good. How are you?
Doing well.
Aaron, tell us about what you do to get back on your feet after going through something rough.
Things that I do is that I usually reach out to my friends and family. And because I know they've always got my back, even though sometimes I act like I really don't need them, but I do. And another thing is I listen to music because music and singing is my passion and always makes me feel better.
Awesome.
So I try very hard to distract myself from the sadness so I can move on and accept what's happened.
What kind of music helps you get through that? Is there any particular genre that you listen to?
I really like listening to classical music.
Classical music. Oh, wow.
And indie.
Indie.
Nice indie music.
Ooh, cool. And also K-pop as well sometimes?
Yeah, of course.
All right. So we heard that you're going to be singing a little something for us today. Can you tell us about that song?
Mm-hmm. The song is If We Hold On Together by Diana Ross.
Oh,
okay.
Let's hear that whenever you're ready.
Okay. Souls in the wind must learn how to bend, seek out a star, hold on to the end. Valley, mountain, there is a fountain, washes our tears all away. If we hold on together, I know our dreams will never die. Dreams see us through to forever, where clouds roll by. For you and I.
Oh,
wow.
Very, very nice.
Gorgeous voice.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
Very, very nice. All right. Well, Erin, unfortunately, we have to say goodbye to you. Thank you so much for sharing that wonderful song, your beautiful voice, and your words of encouragement with us and the ASC family.
Yes, make sure to spread
so
that
much.
Beautiful voice to others, and it'll be a great help to them. Yeah.
All right.
Thank you so much. And also, guys, thank you for being in my life, because
no problem.
Guys made me so happy.
Thank you for being in ours.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.
We'll talk to you soon.
Bye.
Love you. Bye-bye.
Mm-hmm. Bye. Love you too.
All right. We'll be back in just a few moments, so don't you go anywhere.
Everybody knows 이건 밀당의 고수 날 들었다 놨다 한 girl each day realize again 밀당의 고수 난 웃었다 울었다 헷갈리는 girl baby girl you're queen of pushable pushable Girl, it's the real life, okay. baby girl, you're queen of Boo-shaboo, 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 Boo-shaboo. Everybody knows Piga.
All right, it's already time for us to wrap up today. Yesterday and today, the F School Club took a slightly different turn from what we usually do, but thank you so much for joining us and tuning in for these special, special episodes.
Yes, and sharing with the ASCers gave me a lot of comfort and just made me feel like I got close to all of our ASCers out there, just talking with our experiences.
Yes.
And just sharing our thoughts just made us really close, so I'm grateful for this time.
Yes. Of course, nothing can really completely compensate for the pain and the hurt
yes.
that people are going through, but I think it's good to share our express our pain and the grief that we're going through, and we're very thankful that we can share in the sadness and the sorrow, but also look for the bright light at the end of the tunnel. So please be sure to tell somebody, whoever it is, that you love them.
Yes, and we also want to be here for you guys whenever you're down. And when you guys are going through hard times, we're always here for you guys. So please don't hesitate to ask us for prayers or your comfort whenever you want to. So just make sure that you can ask us anytime, and we're here for you guys.
Yes, stay positive, be loving, be caring. Peace, love, unity for everybody. Yes. We'll be back next Tuesday at 1 p.m.
All right, we'll be waiting for you. Please join us next week. See you guys.
Have a good week. Bye.